Hello and welcome to the latest edition of the New Haven Independent Vlog News Summary, direct from our newsroom, otherwise known as my compost heap. Let's see what stories are working on this week. Now that's strange. A recycling bin for bottles and cans in the compost pile. How'd that get here? Well, you know what? I've been looking for these recycling bins. On Monday, we had our trash pickup as usual, and our two recycling bins, plus, you know, those big garbage bins you put your bags in, they all disappeared. I looked up and down the street. It'd been kind of windy. None were there. So what did I do? I do what people in New Haven now are supposed to do, at least. We go to something called Web 311. You go to the city's website, you go to the bottom, and there's a place where you put in a complaint and try to get an answer. I said, here's a chance to check it out. This is new. Let's see how they're doing. Well, I had a good experience. I put in my request. I said, what do I do about this? They're all disappeared. They're not up and down the street. Within hours, I got a response from a city official, and it was a clear response. They said, call this number, the police department reported. Call this number, Public Works, tell them what's up, and they'll help you out. I did that, and it worked. I even learned a new word, toter. That's what those big bins are, where you put your garbage bags, they dump them in, toter. I never knew about that. Anyway, I went and got two of those, I went back and got a recycling bin for the bottles and cans at Public Works, and they claim they're going to deliver the other one, that they do that. Nice service. Now remember, this government is run by Democrats in New Haven, okay? Hold that thought for a minute as we look for other stories. What else we got here? I got a bottle of aspirin in the compost heap, and boy, I could use one of those this week. I went to a government agency run by Republicans, and boy, that was a different story. Not that this is what they're always like, but I'll tell you why I'm saying this. The Department of Motor Vehicles. My wife and I were taking our daughter to get a driving test. Now, it used to be a hassle going to the Department of Motor Vehicles way back in the 80s. It's been since 1986 that we've elected a Democratic governor in Connecticut. So Republicans have been running this government. First it was an independent Republican, then Republicans. These days, the Department of Motor Vehicles is run by a guy named Robert Ward, really good guy, former state rep, conservative Republican, who always would say that liberal Democrats spend too much money and don't run government well, and that was the mantra. Now he's in charge, and let me tell you, that place is more broken than ever after all these Republicans, and he's been there long enough, and it's ridiculous. Okay, so to take your driving test is what we found out. You don't go twice anymore, you go three times for hours each time in this cockamamie bureaucratic process. First you go in to get your permit. That takes hours, of course. It shouldn't, but it does. Then you don't come back next to take a driving test. They don't let you make an appointment. You come back to get an eye test for 10 minutes or less and to retake a written test. And even that takes hours. They got to move the paper after you take, before you take a while to get the test, and they move the paper to some bin. And then after a while, you ask someone, is our paper in that bin? Oh, yeah. And then they type something in a computer. Then you come back again for hours again to take the test. Democrats don't always run government well, but Republicans are full of it when they try to use that cheap excuse not to use your money to run government to help people because they say Democrats can't run it. Republicans do an even worse job. What other stories are you working on? Hey, what are these beer bottles doing? I guess I put them in the wine bottles. All these empty booze bottles. You know, it looks like some kind of college party taking place. I wonder if it was down the street, because let me tell you something about down the street. Wintergreen Apartments. That was supposed to be luxury apartments for 293 new apartment holders off Blake Street near the edge of Beaver Hills there. They built it where there was an old factory. At the time they're going to build it, it was way too big, some greedy developer, right? You got a little lane of traffic in each direction that was already too jammed up. You got to put all these apartments there. Well, the neighbors were upset for a different reason. They said, what we're worried about is that you're not really going to be able to fill 293 luxury apartments. You're going to end up making it a student dorm because the college is nearby. And that neighborhood already had problems with Southern students and loud parties in residential neighborhoods. Developers said, no way, and they put conditions, you're not supposed to do that. Well, of course, they're already now, they can't fill those apartments, not even close. So they are advertising at the universities. And then this week, it was Mary O'Leary reporting the Register that University of New Haven actually wanted to get 200 of those apartments as a dorm. Now they found out, whoa, you're not supposed to under the rules of the planned development district. So we'll see what happened with that. But I don't think the private market even works better than government, all these Republican mantras. Let's see what else is working out. We've got this alien hat. Remember the alien hat from Channel 51? This showed up in the compost pile again. I wonder why. Could it have something to do with the news today that astronomers have discovered a solar system like ours only 5,000 light years away? Mm-hmm. Maybe Dennis Kucinich knows something about this. Well, until next time, this is New Haven Independent Vlog News Summary. And remember, always pick up your trash